Hello everyone and welcome to round 4 of the Formula 1 2014 SRL Championship. Today we're in China and once again joining me in the commentary box is Jamie.
Yes, it's Jamie again joining you for this one and we have 16 turns, some putting a lot of stress on the left front tyre and the longest back straight in the calendar to promote some overtaking. We have 28 laps today with another dry race predicted.
So in Season 2, Boseman 11 took the victory followed by his teammate Lil God, with Worms 123 coming home in 3rd place. Silver Legend also took the pole position but ended up finishing off the podium. And after an action-packed race last time out in Bahrain, let's head to the qualifying report.
Welcome to qualifying here in Shanghai, in China, on board with Williams' Sejimet, coming around the final corner, setting himself up nicely for his fast lap of the session. We've got 1 minute 10 on the clock, so this will be his final lap of the session, as we flick it into turn one using the engine and gearbox to slow us down. We give a boot of throttle which runs us slightly wide. It's going to put us wide for turn two as well, and out through three, and now the traction zone up to through turn four. Brace yourself into the hairpin of turn six, brake nice and hard, get a little bit of rear sliding, but he just about misses the gravel on the inside. A bit of flick of oversteer on the exit which will cost him through the sweepers of 7 and 8. Brace yourself through turn 7, try and stay as far left as you can to set yourself up nicely for turn 8, try and hook up the curb if you can, misses it slightly, and now into the double left of 9 and 10. He misses 9 slightly and runs very wide through 10, which will cost him all down this little straight into 11 and into the rest of the snail section of the lap, as we brake nicely, we slightly cut that corner, get a nice exit though on this sort of never-ending 180 degree banked fast at turn 13, setting yourself up for one of the longest straights of the F1 calendar. The DRS line comes up, open your DRS, look at the speed as it climbs to well over 200 miles an hour, look for just before the 100 meter board as you slam on the brakes, downshift as fast as you can. Take a reasonable apex speed. Now into turn 16, this is a make or break for the lap, as the sediment runs slightly wide, delays his throttle slightly. Stay right for the shortest run to the line, and that's a lap around Shanghai.
And at the end of that qualifying session, Malcolm gets pole position with a 136.111, 4 tenths ahead of Goldfish 138, who is in 2nd place with his best qualifying of the season in his Ferrari. Jamie 995 in 3rd, a very close 10/100ths of a second behind, and Silver Legend 2010 in 4th place in the other Red Bull. His first time being outside 1st or 2nd place after quali. Matt Meerkat in 5th in the Force India, doing another good performance there. TJ Robinson in the other Ferrari in 8th. CJam in 9th, a second off the pace. My name's Jared in 12th. And King Wakama in 13th. The last of the qualifiers for this session, as we had two people who unfortunately did not turn up for this event, OCG and Bill 101 Bob.
Here we are then for round 4 of the championship, and it's C. Jammet and King Rockhammer commentating for you today. And here we are on the grid with another pole position from Malcolm, 4 out of 4 so far this season. And here we are starting the race on board with C. Jammet, as the 5 red lights come on, lights out, away we go. And C. Jammet looks like he's got a really good launch off the line, immediately getting past Rafifa, and already side by side with TJ on the running to turn 1. And this corner will only get tighter, so it's going to be more of the place for contact as Aresi goes wide, and C. Jammet just threaded the needle beautifully well there, but gets a tap from Matt Meerkat, and there is a little bit of contact between Jamie 995 and Silver Legend. Matt Meerkat just breezes past, and now up into 2nd place for him, as we now are side by side with Boseman coming into turn 6, and C. Jammet launches it down the inside of Aresi as well. They're going to be 3 abreast on the exit of the corner, and they all get away with it unscathed. So a pretty tidy start so far, everyone is pointing in the right direction, but Malcolm's well out in the lead as Aresi goes wide through the fast left hander, and Boseman's there as well, and they're still side by side through this corner. Wonderful action here so far, and now it looks like it's calmed down a little bit, and there, I think there was a car off to the left there, and I think there was actually, yes, Rafifa launches it down the inside there rather harshly there, and I wouldn't be surprised if he chooses to give back the place. But it looks like TJ's got a good run coming out of the snail section.
Yes, and we're on to the longest back straight in the calendar now. And we got Postman on the left there, I believe, and we got TJ on the right. And it looks like we've got both Ferraris now looking to get down the inside. Oh, and my name's Jared. Goes a bit wide. We've got Postman, and somehow they've made it out of that corner unscathed. TJ Robinson clips the board, goes a bit wide, but gets away with it, and we carry on. And it looks like my name's Jared there behind is battling now with Postman, and they drop back after that, actually. Probably got a bit scared there or something like of the like. And after that, great start for C-Jammit. We are now on lap two.
Yeah, there was a car off to the left-hand side, a Ferrari. And considering there's a Ferrari right in front of us, I believe it was Goldfish who was facing completely 90 degrees clockwise to what the track is. So, fortunate for him, there is a bollard on the last corner. So, he's probably hit that and just spun, unfortunately. But that's not really within the track, so what you get is that's what you get, unfortunately. As C-Jammit is now right on top of these guys, TJ and Rafifa. TJ goes a little bit wide. Will C-Jammit seek the opportunity? And no, he doesn't. He chooses to go to the outside. TJ breaks a little bit later, and C-Jammit misses the apex, so that will be probably an opportunity missed for the Williams driver, as we've got quite the queue. There's two cars getting away out front, and then there's this big queue from third that looks like it goes down all the way to probably about 10th or 11th. So now down into this hairpin, and C-Jammit goes down the inside. There's contact ahead, and that's Matt Meerkat backwards. So again with Rafifa, so Rafifa's not doing himself any good at all. And yeah, unfortunately for him, he lives in a different country, so he's bound to get lag on this game. That's the way it goes, as Manicum sets the fastest lap, and C-Jammit is right on top of Postman.
Yeah, Postman just got passed in there out of the final corner. So C-Jammit has dropped that place there, and he'll be looking to get back quickly, because otherwise my name's Jared, his teammate will be all over him. And yeah, there might be a bit of a team battle going on here between my name's Jared and C-Jammit. They've had quite a few battles already during the season. So we shall see if there'll be anything that ensues there. Postman, looks like he's getting a bit of a gap there. And it looks like we've got lap 2, turn 14 instant involving Matt Meerkat and Rafifa under investigation. This is not a surprise. He's already had quite a few leery moments already, Rafa, due to his lag with C-Jammit on lap 1, as well as Aressi actually taking him out, and now Matt Meerkat. So we'll see what the stewards say about that. So we're going on to the back straight. Mine's Jared gets a bit of a run because C-Jammit gets a bit of oversteer and gets all out of shape out of that corner. It's quite a difficult one to get right, and we do have DRS. C-Jammit got DRS there on Postman, which is very surprising. So that might help him defend for my name's Jared, but unfortunately for C-Jammit, my name's Jared breaks a bit later, and that is a textbook move there. My name's Jared straight down the inside, and C-Jammit could do nothing about that, and now he's down into 8th. So after that good start, his good work is being a bit undone here.
Yeah, very good, very well said there. So hopefully we'll get some replays of the start soon. Jared's looking to pass Postman immediately as he goes wide into turn 1. So Jared getting a bit on the grass. Is C-Jammit going to come back at his teammate around the outside? It becomes the inside for turn 3. Jared turns in, and C-Jammit doesn't care and gets a better run through the corner. But they're still side by side. The Williams teammate once again having a nice ding-dong battle for the back end of the podium, for the back end of the points. And Jared gets the high ground into turn 6 and keeps the position, as we've got the other Mercedes of Lil God looking right behind Lil God on the primes, I believe, as we now get some replays of the start. So this is C-Jammit getting a very good launch off the line, and as we go through this double apex corner, you can see C-Jammit just does beautifully well and just threads the needle, and then it bunches up between the three cars in front, and Matt Maycat on the left just goes straight through up into second place. But later on, he obviously loses those places. Trying to look further up the road, trying to figure out why. So Silver Legend goes down the inside, so he's lost that place.
Yeah, crowds him out a bit there, and he also has that instant leader in the race as well. And we're on a replay of...
Yeah, we don't see that incident with the Rossi, unfortunately. This was rather impressive, as Siege Amets looks like he's about to get swamped. And Jared, very late on the brakes, cuts the corner. So inevitably, you know, he gets compromised on the exit. And if we just look up the road here, let's look on the left. Yeah, look, there's the Ferrari backwards into the wall. So there might have been contact with another car,
but the bollard. Shane, well done there.
The bollard has disappeared. This is the incident being investigated, and you have to say Rafisa's at fault there. You can't just, you know, leave your car half-heartedly in the track like that.
And you are back on board. Ooh. Jeremy goes very late on the brakes, and that's just too much, and he's straight off the track, and Little God takes advantage of that. Who is actually on the prime tyres at this point, so see, Jeremy won't enjoy this now if he catches up on the option tyres, which he inevitably will do on the DRS, so he wants to make the move as quickly as possible, and he's got a good run here to the inside line for turn one. It's very long turn one, but it goes a bit wide. That means Little God will take the undercut into turn two. And that was a bit of a racing incident there, but unfortunately, C. Jammet has been penalised there.
That was clumsy stuff there. So yeah. C. Jammet's unfortunately picked up an in-game penalty. Whether the stewards will make any further decision on that, we'll hopefully see a bit later in the race. But yeah, that's compromised C. Jammet badly there. And it's that looked obviously less obvious than what happened down at the hairpin on lap 2 with Rafifa and Matt Maycat. Lil God's just run completely wide off the track, and CJ Matt's gone straight back through. Is Rockhammer going to follow him through? It looks like he is indeed. As it goes side by side, we can look in the mirrors, and they're still side by side through the corner, and Lil God looks to have kept this place. They're still side by side on the exit even, but no, Lil God has kept the position. Is he going to get the run down this straight on Siege Amet? So let's see. And Siege Amet goes defensive, tries to break the slipstream. Lil God has none of it at all, goes back down the inside, and Goldfish as well is there passing Rockhammer, but Lil God's made the move successfully. And Goldfish, having been compromised, having qualified second, his best qualifying result of the season, as you said earlier in the qualifying report, Jamie. And Rockhammer now following Lil God through on the run down into turn one. Will he get? No, he's backed out a little bit. And will they manage to make it through the apex? Rockhammer tries to run him out of road, but CJ Matt has none of it. Side by side through turn three, and Rockhammer doesn't gain the position.
Yes, this is not looking good for CJ Matt now. After having a great start on lap one, he's now down in ninth, with a car who is on the prime tyres up ahead, which should not be happening for CJ Amet, so he's not enjoying his options very much at all. He's only done a 140 for his best lap, and he's going to want to get a move on and start calming things down now. Lots of oversteer and instants and things for CJ Amet is not helping him whatsoever. Little God goes a bit wide. Will that help CJ Amet onto this small straight here? And it doesn't look like it. It's not long enough. 1 second up on his pace, so yeah, definitely getting things all out of shape over the past few laps, which means he definitely needs to calm things down. We are going on to the longest back straight on the calendar. It's about 1 kilometre long, so even though it looks like there's quite a bit of a gap, will he be able to make any ground, any large amounts of ground on him?
Watch for Goldfish behind.
Goldfish as well behind. He's also got the DRS. Quite good straight line speed there. Gets past CJ Amet, goes a bit wide, which gives CJ Amet maybe an option to possibly get back past, but no, Goldfish has got that place and is on a recovery driver after his incident with Bollard on the final corner. They are side by side now. CJ Amet is selecting the wet tyres for some reason, but anyway, and Goldfish still got the position. We'll see Jamit try his trademark move at the moment by going down inside. No, he won't. It gets a bit cut off there from Goldfish. So that was not going to happen. And Goldfish says, well, just showing what you can do on the option tires, where C Jamit is just sitting around behind at the moment.
He dives down the inside into six, though. A bit of a late move, but Lil God sensibly leaves in space, and there was contact on the exits. Goldfish being really unnecessarily aggressive there towards Lil God, you know, trying to run him out of the road, even after the corner. That's not really the best of things to see. Is C Jamit just gets a much better run through that corner for whatever reason. So obviously we have the softs and the mediums here, and on this game there's such a difference between the two compounds that you go slower on the primes than you do on an old set of options. So that's proving the way to be so far, as C Jamit's now got a little bit of a gap towards Lil God, but really struggling out of that 12 and 13 corner that leads onto this back straight. And that's cost him against Jared, and it's cost him against Goldfish, and could well cost him again here as he leaves it late on the brakes again, locks up the front right, and Lil God's goes straight back through, and a little bit of contact there, but they both get away with it.
Yeah, he is not heeding my advice of getting a bit calmer now. He's still making a few errors, and Lil God has got past again. This is becoming quite a bit of a battle between the Mercedes and the Williams here. C Jamit is getting a bit frustrated now, dives straight back down the inside and has got the precision. I think the Lil God probably went a bit wide there, which made the move quite easy for C Jamit, and is back up into 8th and hoping to start following Goldfish now and start getting back up the field during the remainder of this race.
Yeah, there was contact further back as well in the mirror between Lil God and Rockhammer, but I think Rockhammer might have got running again, as we can now see a 10 second time penalty has been given towards Rafifa for causing a collision, and I presume that was obviously with Meerkat down at the hairpin. So nothing been given for the one with the Ressi. Maybe that will just be left as it is, but at the start of the lap, similarly to what happened with Lil God and C Jamit, Rockhammer and Lil God also came together, and Rockhammer I think has lost out a position. So don't know whether there'll be anything done on that, but Lil God is now in the slipstream behind, and with the DRS it's an easy pass really down that 1 kilometer back straight. And C Jamit tries to come back on the brakes, but makes nothing of it. Will he go on the pit lap? He's being asked to and requested to. So, let's see. And he does go straight into the pits. So, here we go. Let's see what tyre compound he goes onto before he selected the wets. Nope, he's staying with the options.
Yeah, let's see what the Williams boys can do today on this very fine afternoon in China. Let's have us hope for the best. No holding up by the looks of it. It should not be. No other cars in the pit lane. And we got a 3.7 pit stop. Fairly standard as per usual. And we are selecting open to standard now for the pit lane exit on the cold option tyres. Right, C Jamit on this stint will be wanting to make up some ground now. He had a very poor first stint. And now we are skipping up to the end of lap 9. Got some heat in the tyres now. We've done a 157 for the out lap. We don't know whether that's good or not. There's a car in the pits. I'm not sure who that is. But we are now on a recovery drive, I think. And we've got Busman up ahead. So C Jamit's first target will be him.
Yeah, a few other people pitted as well on lap 9. So, yeah, we're going to have a lot of... We're going to have plenty of differing strategies. We're going to have people who started on the options who have gone to primes, and other people who have gone to options. A couple have started on primes like Lil God and Rockhammer, so it's going to be interesting to see how they feed out later on in the race with their option tyres, whilst everyone else will be on the medium. So here we are on board with C Jamit catching Boseman, who is on the medium tyre at the moment, and Goldfish is behind us. He had to stack behind his teammate in the pit lane. We did get a camera angle of that, but didn't pick up on it, unfortunately. So He would have probably gone to the option tyres, knowing that he likes to go through the fastest stages in the race as quickly as possible. So now concentrating on C-Jamek, both man lengths, makes a little bit of a late move, and C-Jamek gets a nice move down the inside, stops the car beautifully well, and down the inside, Silver Legend sets the fastest lap on a fresher set of tyres, and C-Jamek nails that last apex, puts it up into Rich Mitts, and sets the fastest lap himself. So yeah, as Boseman in the mirrors is coming back, and a 10 second penalty for C-Jamek has been reversed by the steward, so that's more seen as a racing incident, which is fair enough, because C-Jamek was there like more than half a car length up the inside of Lil God, and you know, the Williams can't just disappear at Lil God's request. So yeah, rightly so, I would say that C-Jamek's penalty has been removed, and now the Williams is up into 7th place.
Yeah, probably a bit of rage going on where he set that fastest lap, trying to get on it as quickly as possible. But I noticed that C-Jamek is playing a bit of dare with the bollard on the final corner. We know what that can do if you get it too wrong, as we've seen Goldfish already, so he's got to be careful with that from now on. We've overtaken Boseman, and now we are looking at the scary Rafifa, you have to say, catching up him now on these option tyres. We are on lap 17, so we're over half distance now. We've got minus one lap of fuel, so yes, we're already in lean, so we're obviously saving a bit of fuel at this point just to get that back up to optimal, or even plus one lap if he wants to go into Rich for a bit at the end of the race to possibly use it for attacking. We're 1.4 seconds behind, and Boseman is now 6 seconds back after we overtook him earlier in the stint. So C-Jamek is making these options work eventually, and starting to get some good ground now. So we won't have the DRS on this straight. We might be able to get a bit of slipstream, but obviously on this game the slipstream is quite powerful, but we get quite a poor exit there, so that might have cost us a bit of time. Rafifa is doing okay up in front, doing everything he needs to do at the moment, not making any mistakes. If he does make a mistake, C-Jamek might be able to get on top of him. We're in Rich Mitts, but obviously his slipstream is not making any difference here, and we're on our own at the moment.
Yeah, Rafifa, I think, just defended fresh air until that happened for some reason. Oh, and he goes into pits. C-Jamek also follows the Sauber up into the pits. So Rafifa at the moment looking good, but we also must bear in mind the penalty that he has as well, coming in later in the race. So that if there's like a safety car later on during the race, it could well and truly shake up the order, as we saw in Bahrain. So C-Jamek in for his second pit stop. Let's see if it is as good as the first. About 3/4 of a tenth slower, but a good enough stop from the Williams team, and we're joining out in 12th place with only Goldfish behind. Goldfish really having a race to forget.
Yeah, the prime tyres now for C-Jamek, the slower tyre, which he has to use, so we shall see if C-Jamek can make them work for him. Rafifa still out in front. The gap has closed a little bit, I'd say. We're down into standard mix for this corner, and we've got a bit of nice Mario Kart in there, and Rafifa might have went a bit wide there, I think, into that corner, so that has reduced the gap even further. So C-Jamek is just wanting to get this gap down as quickly as possible, because he needs to start making some moves. I mean, we're in 12th place. This is not good for the Williams team. They had a bad race out in Bahrain, so we don't need this again. And 1.4 seconds. It's not, the gap hasn't really changed, but quite a good series of corners there from C-Jamek, getting even closer all the while. We're on lap 18, and it's Goldfish. We should have some pitters now, actually.
We'll certainly be watching the mini-map for that then. And into the last corner, no doubt if we fly down the pit straight, we'll make up some more positions soon enough, because we have got other people like Rockhammer and Lil God still to go on the options. So C-Jamek will definitely go up a few more positions by the time the rest of the people make their pit stops, But C-Dammit's looking pretty comfortable for a points finish at the moment. But the man behind Goldfish is miles behind everyone. He's 11.3 behind the second to last guy at the moment. So he is honestly having a race to forget here, and might actually struggle to finish within the points. But at the moment, C-Dammit's on the back of Rafifa, closed up during that last phase of the lap, and as he gets a little bit of oversteer on the, well, on the apex of the corner unusually. So struggling a little bit for pace is Rafifa, as he understeers almost completely off the track. So not happy with the balance in that Sauber at all, as he misses the apex of that corner. Again, does C-Dammit dare to go down the inside? Yes, he does. And Rafifa gets better exit speed, and now down into turn 11, which this is sort of the snail section of the track. Go through turn 12, and then you've got this long right-hander of 13, which prepares you for this long back straight, the longest of the calendar. Now down the, all the way down the far straight, and C-Dammit's got DRS, flies down the outside, and Rafifa tries to come back on the brakes. C-Dammit sensibly leaves a car's width, and that is position gained for the Williams driver. And now on the minimap we can see more pitters. So yep, Jamie, you were right on that one.
And we are on the pit straight now. We've done a 1:39.7, 2 seconds slower than our last laps. So as you can see, the points are definitely slower. TJ Robinson is just in front of us after those pit stops. And can we get past him whilst he's on his colder tyres? But I don't think that's going to happen in time. Rafifa there, you saw the arrow markers, still looking to get back on C-Dammit. But yeah, C-Dammit's going to be looking at TJ quite a lot. They're having a bit of a championship battle, as we can see the championship battles are now forming. So any extra points is always good. And C-Dammit's got the DRS now on lap 21, but we're getting closer ever so slowly every lap. And TJ is very slow through that corner, gained some good ground there, and now we're right on top of him.
So it looks like fifth place is on the cards for C-Dammit, which would be a very good result for him considering that the tough season he's had so far in race trim anyway. Considering that he had a brilliant pole in a brilliant third place in Malaysia, but yet spoiled by King Rockhammer, and we've not really seen much of him today. But we did see his name come up along the pit straight, so he's pitted, trying to make himself go back through the order further down the field. But for now let's concentrate on this battle for fifth place, this three-way battle for fifth place. 10 points on the cards here, and TJ is the one who's looking to keep that at the moment. But C-Dammit for once has got a very good run out of the turn 12 and 13 now, all the way down this back straight. Goes to the inside, TJ doesn't defend for once, and now down the... Oh, TJ's come back into the slipstream. Will he come back on the brakes? Yes, he does, and flies straight off the track, and that is position gained for C-Dammit. And Jared up in fourth place as well. This could well be a very good double points finish for the two Williams. But as I say that, C-Dammit's gone a little bit wide, and now he's the one defending on the run down into turn one, and TJ flies straight back through.
Yes, the balls on the last corner sent C-Dammit wide, so that didn't help at all. After gaining that position, the TJ, he's lost it straight away again, and that might have frustrated C-Dammit a bit there. We're coming out of turn two. Will C-Dammit be able to do anything? But no, he won't. Quite a poor exit there. So TJ is a bit late on the brakes there. Luckily, no contact to be made there. And now we are heading down to the left and the long right. It was a bit wide there, C-Dammit, which ruins his line for this right-hander. And TJ, it's definitely within range, but he's also got to watch out for Rafa behind, who is actually not making much moves at the moment, and not being able to get involved in this battle. TJ gets a bit leery there onto the hairpin, and onto this long back straight, but see Jamit yet again. Not a great exit from him. And we've got the DRS coming up now. Might be a bit too far back to make any moves here. Definitely getting a bit closer, but I don't think it's going to work. No, it doesn't. Just sticks behind. And a bit wide there, not hitting the apex as well as he would have liked. We're coming up to the pit straight now. And see Jamit runs right again, but so does TJ. Will this allow Rafa? No, he won't. He's too far behind at the moment, but he's definitely got closer as a result of that. We are in minus one lap of fuel, so we need to do some more fuel saving by the end of this race if we are going to make it. And now we are skipping to lap 26. As you can see, TJ has now made a bit of a gap to see Jamit. 5.4 seconds. Rafa is only 0.004 behind.
I don't believe that for a second.
No. And there's also a good battle between them two as well. Little God and Rafa having a bit of a battle. We know Rafa lags, so we've got to be a bit careful as a Little God. See Jamit gives the slipstream to Little God, who's also got the DRS, and he flies straight past See Jamit. Amazing straight line speed, you have to say, from Little God, of battling Rafa just a minute ago. And has got past the pair of them down that really long straight. And Rafa has also got past See Jamit, who absolutely destroys the bollard there.
So here we go on a run down to turn one. Rafifa tries to come back and Lil God has none of it. Oh, that sent Lil God spinning, and that is a rather weird accident. Hopefully we get a replay of that, because that was a very weird accident indeed. Hopefully Lil God's got up and running again, and that's not compromised him too badly with two laps to go. But yeah, unfortunately we got that really sad case of lag. As you can see over the sector splits, where it says he's 4 thousandths behind and then 23 thousandths behind, when clearly he's a tenth or two behind the Williams. So yeah, it'll be interesting if there'll be any stewards inquiries on that as Lil God disconnects in rage, unfortunately. So yeah, Brafifa's been getting himself caught in a lot of incidents this race. And again, he just carelessly puts it down the inside of a driver, and that's the thing that's really compromised him today, because you run the risk of, one, damaging your front wing when you just carelessly place it against the tyre of another car, and you compromise not only your own race but someone else's race, which could result in a penalty, as Lil God's teammate Boastman does exactly the same as his teammate, except see Jamit just doesn't care that the Mercedes is there and turns in regardless of whether the Mercedes is there or not. But he's kept the place, and both of them have got away unscathed as Steve Jamit once again runs wide on the exit. Minus one lap of fuel, so he's not safe, but still defends into turn one regardless. And Boseman just cruises around the outside, and you have to say that will be the Mercedes driver just gone. So through turn three, are we going to be able to get to the end of the race? We're on minus one lap of fuel, and we're pretty much going to have to run lean the entire of the last lap to be able to try and be able to get over the line. And Lil God has now decided to quit the internet, so much is his rage from that incident on the last lap. So unfortunate to see, but there's not much you can really do when there is so much lag going on. So Rafifa is going to probably have to think twice in the next few races, or probably have to leave the league until the connection problems are sorted. But for the remainder of this race, couple of corners to go. Malcolm has dominated this Grand Prix, you have to say, just by looking at the minimap. And the next car is absolutely miles behind, as CDM is struggling for traction out of turn 12 and 13. And on the back straight for the final time on the run down to the hairpin. And doesn't look like there's going to be any last lap moves down into the hairpin. Although Rafifa is catching us down into the corner. Is he going to lunge it down the inside? No, he's defending from Aresi, I believe it is. And let's see how that goes through this last corner. Into it we go. And Aresi's just flown off the track there. And across the line we come for a solid sixth position, and this is replay of the referee for a little god incident. Okay, so they're behind, but Rafifa's behind, and then it's a very peculiar incident because Rafifa just stops. So, I have no idea there, but this is the race winner Manicum, and a dominant win in the end. I actually completely forgot he was in the race. So it was very quiet out front this race, but here is the classification of the result.
Manicum won by nearly 15 seconds from his teammate Silver Legend 2010 in second. Damon 905 in third in his Sauber. A very strong showing from him, just 20 seconds behind. My name's Jared in fourth in the a very good result for him in the Williams, who need it at the moment after two bad races. TJ Bomerson doing well for Ferrari, where Goldfish 138 didn't. Boseman 11 in sixth in the Mercedes. C Jammet in 7th. Aresi 666 in 8th. King Rockhammer in 9th in the McLaren, 56 seconds away from the winner. Rafa in 10th after all his incidents. Matt Meerkat in 11th, and Goldfish 138 after his incident on the pit straight in 12th.
And with that race victory for Manicum, he now reduces the gap down to 10 points, and Boseman makes his way back up to third against Goldfish. TJ maintains his fifth place and Jared jumps up to sixth. Jeremy905 also jumping up to seventh place. Lil God raid quitting from the Grand Prix in the end drops down to eighth place. Matt Meerkat getting no points on the board after that amazing start, getting up to second place. So he dropped back through the field quite dramatically towards the end. And C Jammet maintaining his 10th place with 14 points, Aresi dropping down to 11th, and OTG and Bowen on Bob going down as well. Rafifa getting 1 point to his championship tally, but it makes no difference as he's still down in 15th.
And in the Constructors' Championship, Red Bull get even more points over Ferrari with 162 points now, looking quite ominous there for the rest of the season. Williams move up to fourth place after My Name's Jared does very well for the team with 36 points, moving ahead of Force India, who are in fifth. Sauber Ferrari here with 20 points, moving up ahead of McLaren and Lotus, who are in seventh and eighth respectively with 13 points apiece.
So that concludes the Chinese Grand Prix, and that has been round four. Join us again for round five, where we'll be in Spain and we start the European season. Goodbye.